Hello, this is Eric D. Kirk for mamoworld.com, and welcome to part 4 of our tutorial series about using JSON data in After Effects. In this part, we take a look at the actual expressions that our free extension, mamoworldJSON, creates to link properties to a JSON document. In the first part of this series, we'll link the text for the wind, the pressure, and the humidity to these values here in the JSON file. One thing that I find not optimal yet is that in the JSON file, we still have to enter the entire text, including the formatting. Wouldn't it be great if we would just have to enter 2 instead of 2 miles per hour? So let's replace it by 2, and then find a way to append the miles per hour in After Effects. In the special case that your values are just numbers, you can even skip the quotes, so let's delete them for now. If we reveal the source text property of the text layer showing the wind, you can see that mamoworldJSON applied an expression to it. This is what mamoworldJSON always does to connect a property to the JSON file. As you can see, the expression looks pretty complex, but the only thing that we need to understand is the very first line. It means, please use from the mamoworldJSON file the value with the name wind. The rest of the expression just contains all the details how exactly this value is retrieved, but we don't care about those details. You can really treat this expression as a simple single-line expression that retrieves the wind value with this statement. To append miles per hour to it, we simply write plus, and then in quotes write mph. As you can see, the miles per hour is now appended to the value. Let's just add a space here, and now it looks pretty good. Now let's go to the pressure text and add the suffix mb in the same way. Also, we'll add a percent to the humidity value. Since these suffixes are still included in our JSON document, we have them twice now, so we go back to the JSON file and make sure it only contains the numbers. Appending text is just one simple example how you can modify the expressions generated by mamoworldJSON. If you link position values, for example, you can also add offsets or do any other kind of math with these numbers. In the next part of this tutorial series, we will cover a more advanced example of this when we link the graph here at the bottom to the JSON document. Again, this is Eric D. Kirk for mamoworld.com, and we'll see you next time.